people show power. In Kali Yuga, there is no power. It's only show of power. The big car you have, more power you have. The iron starch dress you have means you have more power. The way you walk, you show your power. Devotees also show power, right? In the beginning, they are in the front row. After, when they become advanced, they go last row. Because if you are sitting in the front row, means you have no power. All junior people sit in the front. All senior people go in the back. So, but how much can you show? It is only manorathena. It is only showing in our mind. You cannot get real power. You can show power. So material world, in Kali Yuga especially, these are all very much limited because people's understanding are centered around the gross senses and gross material things. So when you are attracted to the gross material things, your enjoyment is also limited. But when you go Vedic understanding, where there is subtle energies are understood, then your enjoyment is also high, heavenly enjoyments, yogic power enjoyment. A yogi can sit under a tree and he can go all over the universe. That is enjoyment. You are sitting under the tree, but you are able to go wherever you want. You are able to create so many things. You have all these siddhis. That enjoyment is much, much more than eating, sleeping, mating, defending. So people don't accept the Vedic text and understanding, so they don't know the process. Where is the comparison of the enjoyment? Going to all the hotels in Chennai and eat all kind of food. Go to beaches, go to here, there. Mix unlimitedly. But still, where is enjoyment? We know Kardama Muni enjoyed so much, which is yogic power. So enjoyment in Kali Yuga is very limited. Even though they think we can enjoy more by not accepting the Vedas, by rejecting the Vedic knowledge. But by accepting Vedic knowledge, you can enjoy more actually. It's not limited. It's not limited to the body. It is more in the mental plane. And you have power. So these things are not possible in Kali Yuga. So people are enjoying, thinking that they are enjoying when they are not really enjoying. But the process of Sankirtana is in the material level. Eating is fully there. Where is Vairagya? Vairagya with the Nija Bhakti Yoga. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught real Vairagya. Real Vairagya by eating. Real Vairagya by dancing, which is very much liked in Kali Yuga. People want to dance, but they want to drink and dance. If you don't drink, you cannot dance. But that doesn't give them enough pleasure. How much pleasure it can give you? So everything that in Kali Yuga people think are gross satisfaction is engaged in Sankirtana by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, eating, dancing, pleasurably. So that is the difference in Kali Yuga, where you cannot accept the Vedas, where you cannot follow the Vedas, where people can't understand Vedas. Then the process is naturally, when they don't understand Vedas and Vedic things, there is no Vairagya, there is no tapas. People are centered around enjoying. So the same enjoyment is converted into Krishna conscious enjoyment by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, by Sankirtana movement. So the process of Sankirtana movement is very, very pleasurable, very, very enjoyable.